Hello my friends, in this video we will look at the Ruby Equalizer from Acoustica Audio, which is a recreation of the famous VT5 vacuum tube equalizer from DW Fern. The development of the plugin was conducted under the close eye of Doug Fern and took a great deal of time and efforts. To match Doug's standards, based on his previous experience with the hardware exclusively, the guys at Acoustica had to experiment and refine the sampling processes in ways specific for this unit. As a result, according to the manufacturer, Ruby turned out to be the best equalizer that they have created to date. Is it intriguing? Indeed. But is it really good? Let's see. Let's start by looking under the hood of the plugin. Obviously, Ruby is mostly built of various filters with different shapes. So let's check them first. Among the Ruby filters, we see two low shelves. A low cut, which allow you to cut low frequencies within minus 18 dB. And low boost, which allow you to amplify low frequencies within up to plus 16 dB. The center frequencies available for the low cut and low boost shelves have been carefully selected to address important areas in the low frequency range that often need to be equalized in a mix. The possibility to both boost and cut within the same range allow for both bands to interact and create some unique shapes. This is very similar to how these controls work on the classic Pultec PEQ-1A equalizer. However, both Ruby and the DW Fern VT5 have an advantage over the vintage design, which is the option to select separate low frequencies for the boost and cut bands. In the original Pultec, these are always looped to the same frequency. The mid-cut bell-shaped band has what is called a proportional Q. This means that the bandwidth of the filter increases when we attenuate more, which helps when this band is used to drastically reduce problematic frequencies from the sound source. At low attenuation settings, the mid-cut is very broad, and this is excellent for transparent and minor spectral adjustments of the source. All of this results in a very musical filter. Of course, we could use all of the three aforementioned bands at the same time. For example, by simultaneously attenuating at 400 Hz with low cut and mid cut bands, while amplifying low frequencies with a low boost, you can achieve a significant attenuation of the lower mids of the frequency spectrum. On the bell-shaped high-frequency band, similarly to the Pultec PEQ-1A equalizer, Q-switching is available and the Q-factor again depends on the level of amplification. You can see that at 1.5 kHz we have a much wider filter Q-factor than at other frequencies. Quite an interesting behavior that can be used for soft amplification of the mid-range. The high-frequency shelf also works similarly to a Pultec, but with completely different filter center frequencies. In general, you might get the impression that Ruby, as well as the original VT5 equalizer, is a Pultec PEQ-1A on steroids. And, in a sense, this is true, at least from the user's side. Nevertheless, probably you already noticed yourself that Ruby is designed to work with a broader range of frequencies, and this allows to create fancier EQ curves. VT5 from DW Fern is a vacuum tube equalizer with a recognizable sound character. By activating the preamp, we bring the sound of Ruby closer to the original analog device. You can see here that the more we drive the signal circuit of the plugin, the higher the level of odd and even harmonics generated is. Let's hear how this sounds when in use. As a musical material, we will use the song of Sasha Almazova and non-cadenza band called Seti. Let's have a listen to it with and without any processing made by Ruby. Now let's look at each element of the mix separately, starting with the drums. The first thing to pay attention to is the preamp. You have seen that with its help you can add harmonics to the signal, and we of course will take advantage of this opportunity. Otherwise, why use Ruby if we can simply turn on the standard Pro EQ? In this way, we can get the highly thought after tube character of the original VT5. The equalization curve is adjusted to slightly emphasize low frequencies, soften the low mids, and gently bring up the highs. Now that I attenuate the high frequencies, as with a gain at 5 kHz, the drums began to sound harsh. The weakening of the highs has corrected this issue. Let's listen to the sound before processing and after. Moving on to the bass. Here we use a Pultec-like setting with simultaneous amplification and attenuation in the low frequencies, so that the bass turned out to be solid but not muddy. We do the same with the high mids, both cut and boost simultaneously. Now that I used 1 and 5 kHz as a center frequency of the filter, I hope you have not forgotten that this frequency has special characteristics. If you forgot, rewatch the beginning of the video. I initially did not focus your attention on the preamp, as it goes without saying. Where it is appropriate to use it, we will use it. Do not be afraid to increase the input trim value, a decent amount of harmonics will not damage the bass. But be sensible, if you go too far, you could start losing definition and punch. Let's listen to the sound of the bass before and after processing. With the guitar, the situation is also quite interesting. We crank up the preamp, attenuate the low frequencies and amplify the high mids, while reducing the high frequencies. There are no special surprises here. Let's listen to the sound before processing and after. It sounds sweet, doesn't it? Let's move on to the organ. Here we need some accurate setting so that the instrument does not lose its unique character. A little low boost, a cut in the lower mids and simultaneously boost, and attenuation the high mids work. Again, the magic 1.5 kHz is raised decently, but a reduction at similar degree is also present. Together with the included preamp, it sounds very musical. Let's listen to the sound before and after processing. Working with Rhodes, I tried to emphasize its character by slightly weakening the bottom and low mids, while gently straightening the high mids by simultaneously boosting and cutting in this range. Do not forget that the Pultec-like tricks here can also work magic. Carefully listen to the amount of harmonics added to the signal. If you overdo it by much, the sound of the Rhodes becomes unpleasant. I think you noted that after processing, the instrument it sounds thinner and piercing. Well, it probably does not sound good in solo, but in the mix, it allows for the instrument to be revealed in all its glory. More tone, less mud. Let's listen to the sound before and after processing. Moving on to the most interesting part, the vocal.
Я попала в твои сети. Скажешь, хочешь лететь, лети. Значит, сделано все верно. Я поймала тебя первой. Я попала в твои сети. Скажешь, хочешь лететь, лети. Значит, сделано все верно. Я поймала тебя первой. Я попала в твои сети. Скажешь, хочешь лететь, лети. Значит, сделано все верно. Я поймала тебя первой.
You can see that I did not engage the preamp. It is because of the way they were recorded, and thanks to a well-chosen microphone and preamplifier. They already have plenty of harmonics, so I don't want to overdo this. With the Ruby preamp on, the vocal sound becomes less dynamic and I don't like it. On the other hand, if you happen to have to revive a dull, soulless vocal recording, turn on that preamp and enjoy what it adds. Let's return to my equalization decisions. I slightly rebalance the low frequencies by simultaneously amplifying and cutting them. Slightly cleared the rumble around 400 Hz and created a high mid peak while softening the high frequencies above it. Such settings turned out to be very musical. Let's listen to the sound before and after processing.
Я попала в твои сети. Скажешь, хочешь лететь, лети. Значит, сделано все верно. Я поймала.
I processed the backing vocals in the context of the mix, so I decided that it would not hurt to make them stick out less, as they dragged too much attention. That is why all my adjustments were focused in reducing the low frequencies and the low mids. Oh yeah, the preamp is off. There is no point in adding harmonics to what we're trying to drown a little in the mix. In addition, I think you hear that the original recording is already saturated, so you should be careful with adjustments. Let's listen to the sound before and after processing. After all, while processing the master channel, I just slightly highlighted the high frequencies, this by simultaneously gently boosting and cutting them. The adjustment is so minor that it is barely audible, but if you listen carefully, you will notice that this makes the mix sound a bit more open. Finally, let's listen again to the sound of the mix before Ruby's processing and after it. The guys from Acoustica Audio did a truly fantastic job creating this digital version of the stunning Doug Fearon VT5 equalizer. But unfortunately, the price can be quite steep for many, and at €235, it is not Acoustica's most affordable plugin. However, if we take into account the cost of the original VT5 at $9,100, this seems reasonable. But if you aren't able to spend that much, I would simply not recommend you to install and try Ruby. Once you've heard it, it will not let you sleep peacefully. This is an amazing equalizer, which once heard just make you crave to use and have it. Thank you very much for your attention. Visit us at yourshofmix.com, subscribe to our updates in our social networks, and do not forget to follow the release of new videos on Yourshofmix YouTube channel. See you soon! Swim to the sound!